Mercury. The temperatures on Mercury's surface are extreme and can vary greatly depending on the time of day and location on the planet. During the day, the temperature on the planet's surface can reach up to 800 degrees Fahrenheit or 430 degrees Celsius, making it one of the hottest places in the solar system. However, at night, the surface temperature can drop to about minus 180 degrees Celsius, making it one of the coldest places in the solar system. The extreme temperature changes on Mercury are caused by its thin atmosphere, which is unable to retain heat. As the planet rotates on its axis, the side facing the Sun heats up rapidly, while the side facing away from the Sun cools down just as quickly. This results in a significant temperature gradient across the planet's surface. Despite these extreme temperature fluctuations, there are regions on Mercury that remain relatively stable in temperature. Craters located near the poles of the planet, for example, are permanently shadowed and can remain at temperatures below 180 degrees Celsius. Overall, the temperature on Mercury's surface is inhospitable for life. Venus. Venus, the second planet from the Sun, has a surface temperature that is incredibly high, with an average temperature of about 462 degrees Celsius. This makes it the hottest planet in our solar system, even hotter than Mercury, which is closer to the Sun. The extreme temperature on Venus is primarily due to its thick atmosphere, which is composed primarily of carbon dioxide and nitrogen. This atmosphere traps heat from the Sun like a greenhouse, causing the planet's temperature to soar to extreme levels. This is known as the greenhouse effect, which is also responsible for Earth's moderate temperatures. In addition to its thick atmosphere, Venus's surface is covered in a layer of sulfuric acid clouds, which reflect and absorb sunlight, further contributing to the planet's high temperature. These clouds also cause a runaway greenhouse effect on Venus, where the heat trapped by the atmosphere leads to more cloud formation, which in turn traps more heat. The high temperature on Venus has other consequences as well. For example, the planet has no water in liquid form on its surface, and the pressure on the surface is about 90 times that of Earth's, making it inhospitable to life as we know it. Earth. The average temperature of Earth is approximately 15 degrees Celsius. However, temperatures can vary widely depending on location and time of year. For example, temperatures in the Arctic and Antarctic regions can be well below freezing, while temperatures in desert regions can soar above 38 degrees Celsius. During the winter months, temperatures in the Arctic can reach as low as minus 50 degrees Celsius, and in the Antarctic, temperatures can drop as low as minus 89.2 degrees Celsius. These frigid temperatures are due to the polar regions receiving less sunlight and having more ice and snow cover, which reflects sunlight back into space and further cools the atmosphere. In addition to these regional variations, Earth's temperature also fluctuates on a global scale over time. This can be due to natural factors such as volcanic activity, changes in solar radiation, and variations in the planet's orbit and axial tilt. However, human activities such as burning fossil fuels and deforestation are also contributing to a rapid increase in global temperatures, a phenomenon known as global warming. Mars. Mars is a terrestrial planet with an average surface temperature of minus 63 degrees Celsius. However, the planet's temperature can vary greatly depending on its location and time of day. Mars has a thin atmosphere primarily composed of carbon dioxide, which does not retain heat well, causing the planet's temperature to fluctuate rapidly. During the day, the temperature at the equator of Mars can rise up to 20 degrees Celsius, but at night it can drop to as low as minus 73 degrees Celsius. The temperature at Mars' poles is even colder, reaching as low as minus 143 degrees Celsius during the winter. Mars also experiences extreme temperature changes with the seasons. During the Martian summer, temperatures can rise up to 20 degrees Celsius in the mid-latitudes, while in the winter, the temperature can drop to minus 125 degrees Celsius near the poles. Overall, Mars is a cold planet, with an average temperature of minus 63 degrees Celsius. Jupiter. Jupiter is a gas giant planet, meaning that it is composed mainly of gas and does not have a solid surface like Earth. the temperature of Jupiter varies greatly depending on the depth of the atmosphere being measured. The upper atmosphere of Jupiter, where the visible clouds and storms are located, has an average temperature of around minus 145 degrees Celsius. This temperature is very cold, much colder than even the coldest parts of Earth. The cold temperature of the upper atmosphere is due in part to the planet's distance from the Sun and the fact that it receives only a small amount of solar energy. At the surface of Jupiter, which is not a solid surface like Earth, but rather a layer of gas, the temperature is estimated to be around minus 108 degrees Celsius. As you go deeper into the atmosphere, the temperature increases due to the increasing pressure and density of the gases. At a depth of around 1,000 kilometers, the temperature may reach about 21 degrees Celsius due to the heat generated by the planet's internal energy sources. In the core of the planet, which is believed to be made up of rock and metallic hydrogen, the temperature may be as high as 24,000 degrees Celsius due to the extreme pressure and heat generated by the planet's gravity. This intense heat and pressure create conditions that are unlike anything found on Earth, and may even be powerful enough to generate a small amount of nuclear fusion in the planet's core. Saturn. Saturn's temperature is determined by many factors, including its distance from the Sun, its composition, and its internal heat. Like other gas giants, Saturn doesn't have a solid surface, so its temperature profile is determined by its layers of gas, which get denser and hotter as you move closer to the planet's core. The upper atmosphere of Saturn is composed mainly of hydrogen and helium and is exposed to the extremely low temperatures of space. As a result, the upper atmosphere is very cold, around minus 180 degrees Celsius. Deeper in the atmosphere, the pressure and temperature increase, and at a depth of around 1 bar, which is roughly the same atmospheric pressure as Earth's sea level, the temperature is about minus 140 degrees Celsius. This is the average temperature at cloud level, where ammonia, water vapor, and other substances form clouds and contribute to the planet's distinctive appearance. Moving even deeper into the atmosphere, the pressure and temperature continue to increase. Finally, at the planet's core, which is estimated to be around 20,000 kilometers or 12,427 miles deep, the temperature is estimated to be around 11,000 degrees Celsius due to the combined effects of heat generated by the planet's gravitational compression and the release of residual heat from its formation. Uranus. The upper atmosphere of the planet, which is exposed to space, has a temperature of around minus 224 degrees Celsius. The methane gas in the atmosphere absorbs and reflects sunlight, which results in a cooling effect on the planet's atmosphere. This makes Uranus the coldest planet in the solar system, despite not being the furthest from the Sun. The temperature of Uranus varies depending on its location within the planet's atmosphere. Deeper into the planet's atmosphere, the temperature increases as the pressure and density of the atmosphere increase. At a depth of around 10,000 kilometers, the temperature is estimated to be around 5,000 degrees Celsius due to the heat generated by the planet's formation and continued gravitational compression. However, the core temperature of Uranus is not well understood, as it is difficult to study the planet's interior. Neptune. Neptune is the eighth and farthest known planet from the Sun in the solar system. It is classified as an ice giant planet, and has an average temperature of minus 214 degrees Celsius, which makes it one of the coldest planets in the solar system. The temperature of Neptune's upper atmosphere is around minus 218 degrees Celsius. As you move deeper into the planet's atmosphere, the temperature increases due to the pressure and density of the atmosphere. Deeper into the planet's atmosphere, the temperature continues to increase. At a depth of around 7,000 kilometers or 4,350 miles, the temperature is estimated to be around 5,000 degrees Celsius due to the heat generated by the planet's formation and continued gravitational compression. However, the core temperature of Neptune is not well understood, as it is difficult to study the planet's interior. Pluto. Pluto is no longer classified as a planet and is instead considered a dwarf planet. Nevertheless, Pluto's surface temperature is an interesting topic. The surface temperature of Pluto varies depending on its distance from the Sun as it orbits around it. At its closest point to the Sun, Pluto's surface temperature can reach up to minus 218 degrees Celsius, while at its farthest point from the Sun, the temperature can drop to minus 258 degrees Celsius. Pluto's distance from the Sun, along with its highly elliptical orbit, plays a significant role in its temperature.